Hello, I'm Michael Matlube, and this is Schmutzy. In this video, we're going to be talking about a proposal I've made to improve the module's experience in Go, and why it might be useful to you. Then, I'll show you how to download a prototype of the tool and try it out for yourself. My proposal is called Workspace Mode. It allows you to make changes more easily to multiple modules on your file system.
See why this is useful? Let's see how Go works now.
In Go's module mode, you have one main module. That's the module you're editing and building your code from. When building that module, Go selects the versions of other modules to be built based on the go.mod file of that module and its dependency. Go downloads those versions even if they're available in the local repository. These are read-only copies because they're supposed to represent the module at a given version. So what happens if you want to edit code in a module and in one of its dependencies? You'll have to add replace directives for each dependency module you're working on to your go.mod file. These replacements tell Go to use your code on disk rather than those read-only versions that it downloaded. But managing these replacements is a pain because they only work from the main module. If you work in multiple main modules, you'll have to add replacements to each of the main modules for each of the dependency modules that you're working on. And you'll have to remember to remove the replacements from your main module's go.mod file before you commit your code upstream because they're ignored outside of the main module. Other modules will use the versions that appear in their go.mod files. Workspace mode will allow you to pick multiple main modules. You can pick which modules you're working on, and Go will build those modules, finding the dependencies as usual. And you can put the rest of your configuration outside of your module, so you don't need to remember to remove it before submitting. There's a lot more detail about how the workspace mode works and the problem it solved in the design document, so please check that out if you want more information by using the link on screen or in the description below. In the rest of this video, I'll show you how to download the prototype version of workspace mode using the go tip command to set up VS Code and Go please to use that prototype version, and then do a small demo of workspace mode itself. I hope you try it out and give feedback. Please feel welcome to comment on the workspace issue. Thanks.
Let's install the go tip command. We'll do that by running go install golang.org/dl/gotip at latest, assuming you're running go 1.16 or later. If you're on 1.15 or before, use go get golang.org/dl/gotip. We can use the go tip command to download alternate versions of the go command, such as this experimental one here. We can also use the go tip command to update the experimental version of Go. Make sure your path is configured to use programs you install with Go. Check out the Play with Go tutorial with a link in the description for more information on how. We'll get the latest experimental version whenever we run go tip download dev command go. Besides using go tip download, the go tip command will work just like the go command. So you can pass the go tip command all of the arguments and subcommands that you would use for the go command. Now we've each got our own preferred editors or IDEs, but since VS Code with Go Please is one of the most popular editor environments for Go, I'll show you how to set that up. This demo assumes you already have VS Code set up with a Go plugin. For information for how to set up Go Please, go to golang.org/s/goplease. Let's open VS Code, go to Preferences, Settings, Extensions, Go, and click Edit in Settings.json for alternate tools. It'll add this alternate tools block, and we'll set the Go value to Go tip. Okay, now that we have GoTip installed and the Go plugin on VS Code pointing to GoTip, let's get started with using workspace mode. Let's take a look at an example with three modules. schmutzy.dog/names, schmutzy.dog/tools, and schmutzy.dog/site. The site and tools modules both depend on the names module. Names provides a name constant. And in tools, we have the schmutz command, which was created for this demo. The schmutz command prints out the name. The site module also uses the names. If we wanted to work on all these modules, we could add replace directives in the site and tools modules to replace the name modules. But they're a pain to add and remove, especially if you're working with a large number of modules. In this example, we only have to add one replacement to the tools module for the names module. But as the number of modules you're working on grows, this can get unmanageable. Workspaces provide an alternative. With workspaces, we can tell Go which modules we are going to be working on. Let's create a new workspace by making a new go.work file. To create a go.work file, we use that go tip mod init work command, which takes as arguments a set of directories containing the modules you want to be in your workspace. In our case, those are the tools, site, and names directories. Now, let's take a look at the go.work file that was created for us. This is the go.work file. It contains a go directive at the beginning. That's mostly there for future-proofing, so we can ignore it. Now, the directory directive provides the names of each of the directories relative to the go.work file that contains the modules that we want to be in our workspace. Those are the tools, site, and names module. Note how these all go on their own lines. The syntax of go.work was based on the syntax of go.mod. So similar to how requires and replaces each go on their own line within a require replace block, directories each go on their own lines within directory blocks. Let's open a new VS Code window at the top of our workspace so that GoPlease is aware of all the modules we're working on. Let's add a new function to names that we'll use in tools. Nick will return a slice of Schmutzy's nicknames. And we'll add the dash nick flag to the Schmutz tool to select and print a nickname. Let's parse. And then if the flag is true, we'll print a random nickname. Notice how jump to definition works properly in GoPlease. To jump to the definition of the name and the nick functions. While jump to definition for names.name would still work even outside of workspace mode, it would point to code inside the module cache, not the new code we're working on. And jump to definition to names.nick wouldn't work at all, because the code in a module cache doesn't have the nick function that we added to the development version of the module. Now, because we're in the workspace directory, we can use gotip to build the schmutz tool. Note that this import path is recognized for the build, even though we are not in any one of the modules. Now, let's run the schmutz tool. It works. One more thing, let's talk about the work file flag. It allows you to choose an alternate go.work file, or if it's set to off, turn off workspaces completely. Because our workspace includes all the modules we're using, we can build the schmutz tool even when our current directory isn't contained under any modules, because the current directory is contained under the workspace. But if we don't want the workspace to apply, we can set the work file flag to off. Notice how we can't build the schmutz tool anymore because we can't find the modules it's contained in. Now, if we enter the module, we'll be able to build it even when the work file is set to off, because we're operating in normal module mode. This is something that you'll want to do before you release your code, because your users won't be operating in your workspace. You need to release a new version of the code that adds the API and add a requirement in the module that uses it. Note that the workspace mode prototype is experimental, So we would really like you to try it out and give us feedback, but you shouldn't use it for your production code yet. Please let us know if you find any bugs, and we'll try to fix them as soon as we can.
Thanks for watching. Please feel free to give feedback on the GitHub issue, and let us know about the workflows you have that are or aren't addressed by this proposal. Thanks.